Well, good morning, everyone, and thank you very much for attending today's very important announcement. Good morning, I'm Scott Johnston. I'm the member of the Legislative Assembly for St. James, and I will be the MC for today. Just before we begin, I would like to introduce the speakers for today. My colleague, the Honourable Heather Stefanson, the Minister of Families, Marilyn Valgardson, the Executive Director of Assiniboine's Children's Center, and Sandra Melo, the Principal of Ecole Assiniboine School. I'd also like to recognize my colleague, the Honourable Scott Fielding, who is also joining us today, as well as the Senior Administration of the St. James Assiniboine School Division, Chief Superintendent Brett Locke, and CEO, Secretary Treasurer Mike Friesen. Thank you very much for joining us today, everyone. excuse me. I'd also like to introduce former Councillor Marty Morantz, who is also here today with us today. excuse me. Over the coming months, there'll be plenty of activity on this site, and even more than you might actually expect. Our other speakers will be telling you a bit more about one big development. On behalf of the Minister of Education, the Honourable Kelvin Gertsen, it is my pleasure to tell you a little bit about the important renovations that are going to be taking place at this school, as you can already see. The Manitoba government is investing more than $2 billion in Assiniboine School to ensure it remains safe and a welcoming place. I must say, on a personal note, being a former trustee in this school division and representing this area that Assiniboine School was, what a great community and certainly what a great staff and what a great attribute this school is to the community. The development includes a 900 and 500 square foot roof on the older part of the building, as well as the foundation. Main entrances are being replaced to ensure they are fully accessible. And all of this work is expected to be completed no later than this year, ensuring that the school and community will have access to it for many years. Now I'd like to also to introduce you to the Minister of Families, Minister Stefanson. Minister Stefanson.
Well, thank you very much, Scott. It's great to be here in beautiful, sunny St. James, beautiful area in Assiniboia. Good morning, everyone. Welcome here this morning. It's indeed an honor for me to be here on behalf of our provincial governments to talk about some exciting developments that will soon be underway at Ecole Assiniboine School. Earlier this year, as Scott just mentioned, we announced $129 million for school divisions across Manitoba, which is including upgrades, as Scott mentioned, to this very school that we're here on the grounds of today. We're also pleased to be here today to announce funding for a new standalone daycare for the community. We know that growing the number of childcare spaces is a priority for Manitoba families, which means it's also a priority for our government. To achieve this, we partnered with the federal government on the Canada-Manitoba Early Learning and Childcare Agreements. Through this agreement, we are providing more than $1.8 million in capital funding to build a new standalone childcare center here on the grounds of Ecole Assiniboine School. Our government will also be providing almost $360,000 in startup grant and operating funding under this agreement. This will complement the excellent childcare already provided here by Assiniboine Children's Center. The new facility will include 40 licensed infant and preschool spaces. Once it's complete, in Assiniboine Children's Center will provide 201 spaces here at the school, which is absolutely incredible for the community. For children growing up in the community, that can support a smooth transition from childcare to school and a familiarity with the educators and teachers and many other staff who become their educational family. It's exciting to see this project moving forward, which will soon become a valued addition to the St. James neighborhood, to the school, and for families here in the community. To everyone who has been involved, and many of you are here today, thank you for all of the incredible work that you've done to get us to where we are, and we know that there's still much more work to be done, and we look forward to working with you as your partners. We are proud to be working with you on strategic investments like this one, and we will make we will make a difference for children and families for years to come. So once again, thank you for allowing me to be here on behalf of our Premier Brian Palliser and my colleagues in the Manitoba Legislature. This is an exciting day for sunny St. James, and we look forward to working with you moving forward. Thank you. Merci.
Thank you, Minister. I'd now like to call on Marilyn Valgardson from the Assiniboine Children's Center to say a few words.
Thank you all. Today is indeed an exciting day for us here at Assiniboine Children's Center. This announcement means that the long-awaited expansion of our program is about to begin. We're thrilled to be able to expand childcare in this community and to offer care for 40 more children off our extensive wait list. Assiniboine Children's Center has a strong relationship with Ecole Assiniboine and the St. James community. We've existed in this very space for over 40 years, starting with only 20 children and now soon to expand to over 200. And we've done that all with the ongoing support of the province of Manitoba. We'll now be able to care for children from 12 weeks to 12 years, all in this close proximity. Families will be able to drop off their children in one place at one time. For those of you who have children, you'll know how much that's going to make people's lives a lot simpler. It also will allow children to develop trusting relationships with adults, whether they be in the childcare facility or within the school. Amassing the capital funds for a project this large would be impossible for our small nonprofit organization. Having the capital funding and the ongoing operating funds available will allow us to focus on the important work of early learning and childcare. We are grateful to the vision of the Government of Canada, to the Province of Manitoba for supporting this project, to our local MLA, Scott Johnston, for his ongoing commitment to St. James, and of course to the St. James Assiniboine School Division and Ecole Assiniboine. We look forward to working together in our strong partnership.
Thank you, Marilyn. Excuse me, and now I'd like to introduce and call upon Sandra Melo, the principal of Ecole Assiniboine School.
Good morning, everyone. Bonjour. To the Honorable Heather Stefanson, Minister Fielding, Scott Johnson, and special guests, bienvenue à l'Ecole Assiniboine. First of all, we acknowledge that our school sits on Treaty 1 land, the traditional land of the Anishinaabe, the Innu, and the Dakota people, and homeland of the Métis Nation. We make this acknowledgement in the spirit of reconciliation and in the hopes of repairing all damages done in the past. St. James Assiniboine School Division and its board is proud to be part of the exciting endeavors occurring on our school property and to our school in specific. We're pleased to be part of today's announcement and for all the supports and funds that have been granted to us. From the new daycare to the accessibility enhancements, this community continues to thrive, making Ecole Assiniboine and Assiniboine Children's Center perfect partners for the betterment of our community. Margaret J. Wheatley said, "There is no power greater for change than a community discovering what it cares about." In St. James, we care about all the partners that make us who we are. Our community is only as strong as the families in it. A strong partnership, such as the one between Ecole Assiniboine and the Assiniboine Children's Center, is crucial to keeping the needs of the children and the families in the forefront of all decision making. Daycares and schools are our backbone, thus investing in them is investing in our children and in our families, giving them peace of mind, safe, secure, inclusive buildings and spaces to grow and flourish. De la part de l'Ecole Assiniboine, merci encore. Thank you.
Well, thank you so much for joining us today on such a sunny day and for such a great announcement. We'll now be going to have a group picture, and staff will be organizing us for that. And afterwards, there'll be interviews with the speakers, or people will be available for interviews. So I thank you very much for your attendance today, and please join the rest of your day. Thank you.